World Christian News from English Christian Times. Kerala bishops seek action against terror network. Catholic bishops in Kerala have warned about the increasing influence of international terrorist outfits, such as Islamic State in the southern Indian state. The bishop's call follows a United Nations report, which said there are Islamic State-related terrorists in the southern states of Kerala and Karnataka. Boris Johnson visits Catholic schools in London to push for restarting in-person classes. During a visit to the two Catholic schools in East London, British Prime Minister Boris Johnson said, "It's a moral duty to get students in England back to school in September." Schools across the United Kingdom were closed on March the 20th, 3 days before the country went into lockdown, to slow the spread of the COVID-19 coronavirus. On June the 1st, some classes restarted, but the majority of students have been out of formal schooling for over 4 months. Christian arrested on blasphemy charges in Pakistan. Sohail Masih, a Christian man, was arrested under blasphemy charges after a discussion on eating sacrificial meat at the Eid al-Adha festival in the Punjab province of Pakistan. "It is not possible that the blood of goats and bulls can wash away sins," Sohail Masih posted on Facebook, referring to Laylat al-Miraj or Night of Ascension. Catholic schools in Hong Kong asked to foster correct national identity. As China increasingly extends its influence into its special administrative region, Hong Kong, the Diocese of Hong Kong has also been pressed to tighten its grip on its education system. The Episcopal Delegate for Education Peter Lau Chiu-Yun sent a letter ahead of the start of the new school year in September to the principals and supervisors of almost 200 Catholic primary, middle and high schools, urging the schools under the diocese to help students understand the national security law, respect the national flag and the national anthem, as well as foster the correct values on their national identity. Franciscans of Assisi report 18 coronavirus cases. While Assisi was largely sheltered from a major coronavirus outbreak during Italy's lockdown, 10 Franciscan friars and 8 novices at the landmark pilgrimage destination tested positive this week for COVID-19. On August the 10th, Father Enzo Fortunato, spokesman for the community at the Basilica of St. Francis of Assisi, said that all 18 men are in isolation. Benedict XVI's illness is subsiding. Benedict XVI's personal secretary, Archbishop Jorg Ganswein, has said that the Pope Emeritus's illness is subsiding. In an interview with the German newspaper Satkurier, Archbishop Ganswein is reported to have said that Benedict XVI's illness is subsiding and that his medication has been reduced. Federal court rules, Arkansas abortion restrictions can take effect. A federal court of appeals has removed an injunction blocking 4 Arkansas abortion regulations, from going into effect. The U.S. Court of Appeals for the 8th Circuit ruled Friday to reinstate the 2017 Arkansas laws. They can take effect August 28, although they may still face legal challenge. Argentine bishop says Vatican ordered seminary closed. An Argentine bishop said Friday the seminary in his diocese was ordered closed last month by decision of the Vatican's Congregation for Clergy after a controversy surrounding the reception of the Eucharist during the coronavirus pandemic. Bishop Eduardo Maria Torsic of San Rafael said August 7 that the Santa Maria Madre de Dios Seminary in Mendoza, Argentina, was ordered to close in December at the conclusion of the academic year by the Congregation for Clergy and not the Diocese of San Rafael.